prawie 14 miliardów lat temu. Co to było? Zatrzymajmy się na chwilę. Przecież to najważniejszy moment we Wszechświecie.
Nie z tej ziemi.
Od zarania dziejów ludzkość zastanawia się, skąd to wszystko. Na początku był chaos. Tak sądzili starożytni Grecy. Każda cywilizacja próbowała zrozumieć nasz świat. Jak coś mogło powstać z niczego? I czym jest nic? Czy coś może istnieć zawsze, czy musi mieć swój początek i koniec? Jak w ogóle pojawił się kosmos?
This is the big question, isn't it? And I would say one of the ultimate goals of astronomy and cosmology would be to answer this exact question. It's an incredibly difficult thing to answer. Partly because it's very hard to study the universe before it actually existed. We need to discover new physics to answer this question, and it's then even harder to test these ideas.
Dziś o początkach Wszechświata opowiadać będzie Chris Pattison, doktor fizyki, popularyzator astronomii, pracujący w Instytucie Kosmologii i Grawitacji w Portsmouth. No to Chris, jak to wszystko się zaczęło?
The Big Bang Theory offers an explanation of when the universe came to be. It describes the universe as very hot and dense and energetic right after its formation, and says that that formation was about 13.8 billion years ago. However, and this is perhaps crucial, it doesn't explain how it formed, simply that it did form. And before that, there was nothing at all, until there was something.
Tylko czym jest nic? Nie było przestrzeni, nie było też czasu. Trudno to pojąć, jednak teoria Wielkiego Wybuchu jest podstawową hipotezą początków kosmosu.
The Big Bang Theory is the most commonly accepted idea for the start of the universe. It doesn't really tell us how the universe came to be, just that it did. And the instant that it did, we call that the Big Bang. Our understanding of physics stops at incredibly high temperatures, high pressures, and the small scales that existed at the very beginning of the universe.
Pierwsza połowa XX wieku to głęboki rozwój fizyki, szczególna i ogólna teoria względności Alberta Einsteina. W 1929 roku Edwin Hubble wykazał przesunięcie ku czerwieni galaktyk w swoim widmie. Tym większe im są dalej z naszej perspektywy. Oznacza to, że kosmos rośnie cały czas. Ale dlaczego? Dlaczego pod wpływem grawitacji się nie ściska? Musiałoby na początku być coś, co wszystko zapoczątkowało, twierdzili naukowcy. Ale nie wszyscy. W drugiej połowie XX wieku wielkim przeciwnikiem był Fred Hoyle, który nazwał tę teorię prześmiewczo Big Bang, wielkim wybuchem. Ta nazwa funkcjonuje nadal, tak jak jej założenia.
We don't know how it happened, but the Big Bang theory kind of consolidates all of our ignorance into one short period of time when everything began. People often think of the Big Bang as a single point in space, but really it's a single point in time. In fact, time begins with the Big Bang. And the Big Bang happened everywhere in the universe at the same time. It's just that everywhere was very close together then.
A czy to jedyna teoria początku wszystkiego?
It's definitely not the only one. For example, another idea is one called a bouncing universe. This is a universe that doesn't have a beginning like we describe with the Big Bang. Rather, if we live in a bouncing universe, then that universe has simply always existed. It expands up to a point, then it turns around and collapses back on itself. Eventually, everything is very close together, and some violent process, or bounce, turns it around and expansion begins again. This process repeats again and again, possibly an unlimited number of times. And each time the bounce happened, it's kind of like a little Big Bang, except it makes sense to talk about before the Big Bang in this model. Whereas in the traditional Big Bang model, before the Big Bang doesn't really make sense to talk about. There is simply nothing before the Big Bang in the normal model. There is simply nothing before the Big Bang in the usual model. No time, no space, no universe. So this is one competitor to the Big Bang. There are many others, and it remains very hard to prove or disprove lots of these ideas.
Załóżmy, że jednak początkiem był Wielki Wybuch. Następuje era Plancka, która trwała dosłownie chwilę. Ultra gorący i gęsty punkt ultra silnej energii. Później mieliśmy erę unifikacji, gdzie zaczęła działać fizyka, jaką znamy. Później była już era inflacji kosmologicznej.
Cosmological inflation is a period of time that we think happened right after the Big Bang we were just talking about, in which the universe got very big, very quickly. So it's like the Big Bang happens, the universe, space and time suddenly exist. But it's all very dense and close together in a hot soup of particles. Almost immediately, within the first 10 to the power of negative 33 seconds, that's the first million, billion, billion, billionth of a second, the universe expanded like crazy and increased in volume by a factor of at least 10 to the power of 78. When I first learned about inflation, I learned that that number is called 1 quinvigintillion, and it is a 1 followed by 78 zeros. So it's absolutely huge.
Wydaje się to absolutnie niewyobrażalne. Spróbujmy jeszcze raz od innej strony.
This expansion in a fraction of a second was incredibly fast and increased the volume by an incredible amount. So much so that since the end of inflation, 13.8 billion years ago or so, the universe has increased by the same factor again, just much slower. So hopefully that gives you an idea of sort of the explosive power and speed of inflation. This period of incredibly fast and accelerating expansion is needed to explain a lot of the things we observe in the universe, and a lot of the properties we observe in the universe today. For example, it gives an explanation of why the universe seems to be so flat on the largest scales. It explains why the cosmic microwave background, and it also explains why the cosmic microwave background is pretty much the same temperature everywhere. The cosmic microwave background, or CMB for short, is light that was emitted from everywhere in the entire universe at the same time shortly after the Big Bang, and it is shockingly uniform. And without inflation, we have no explanation as to why this might be the case. Inflation does even more than that too, and actually provides the seeds for all structure in the universe through quantum fluctuations during the expansion. So it's a really important and cool process that happened during the universe's infancy.
Jak powstał wszechświat? Dlaczego? Skąd się wziął? Jak się skończy?